गजेंद्र
थ्री सेक्टर, वन इज इनपुट एंड देन वन नेक्स्ट इज पार्सिंग, नेक्स्ट विल बी द आउटपुट. ओके, इनपुट विल स्क्रैप विल टेल फ्रॉम द लॉग फाइल्स, पार्सिंग विल डू सम काइंड ऑफ जेसन पार्सिंग और एडिंग सम कुबरनेटिक मेटाडेटा लाइक फ्रॉम विच कंटेनर यू स्क्रैप्ड इट फ्रॉम विच नेम स्पेस एंड स्टफ. And then output would be to Kafka, but again it can be to anything, maybe to another file or maybe to Elasticsearch. That you can do that. Okay, so here into this there are two variables that will be passed in. One is the Kafka broker, like which Kafka instance should I send these logs that I scraped to. Okay, the other in is the log stop. This is usually we have default thing saying this thing, unless somebody wants to change it, there's no reason to change it. Okay. Moving on. So that is the first part. Now the logs are now there in the Kafka queue. Okay. Sometimes what happens is that Fluent bit or something gets jammed or locked up once in a blue moon, and that time you just have to restart, and usually it will start connecting again, right? Sometimes when it loses connectivity to the Kafka cluster, it won't be able to push it again. So restarting it usually fixes it. Now that issue that Punjab was facing long ago, so same thing I just did now. I just deleted all the pods, and now they're getting pushed again to Kafka. Okay. But that still does not solve the issue because they don't see it in Elasticsearch, because we deployed now we don't have the client, right? We only have data nodes. So the URL has to change, but the URL is still pointing to the old one in that case. So next is once that is there in that thing, you need to put it in Kafka Connect. You will configure Kafka Connect to get those. Now here you have cluster config, you have Kafka Elasticsearch.
So Fluent Bit has its own adapter to push from after scraping to push on Kafka or?
Yeah, it has its own adapter. Again, there is another output adapter to file, to write it to file, to write it to Elasticsearch also directly.
So
Okay,
readily
so
available, right?
readily available. We don't have to do anything. Just have to pass parameters to endpoint where it has to go. So now what has happened is we've sent this thing to Kafka. Now from Kafka, it has to go to Elasticsearch. Right? So that is the next process. For that, we use Kafka Connect. Now Kafka Connect, we use Kafka Connect in our other things also. We use the normal Kafka Connect. Now you have another Kafka Connect infra that is there. Yeah. Now again, how this also works is same as how that one works. You will port forward to add the configs, and after once you add that main config, it'll keep scraping and pushing things to Elasticsearch. Okay. So in our case, what has happened here?
So, what is Kafka infra, Nitin?
Huh?
What does that Kafka infra pod have?
It has Kafka.
And then what is
So there's two
that
Kafka. Yeah, Kafka, the main Kafka runs the business stuff of it. Kafka infra runs all the logs and all that, because there will be a lot of logs, but because of that logs and lot of data, right? Because logs are usually very huge, because we are used to writing or putting full entire stack traces, request body, and all that in the logs itself, right?
Okay.
So the logs itself are too many. Now, because of that many logs, your delivery of your normal business ones might reduce. Instead of persisting immediately, it might take more time to persist.
Okay.
Right? But we don't want those kind of things to happen, no? Because for that, we, you know.
Kafka infra, you remember we were having to, like, in what chunk sizes does it push on Kafka then? How is it determined?
What do you mean? Chunk size means?
Since Kafka has limit, right? A message limit, which you put on it.
So
that will be in fluent between there, right?
Yeah, that will be in fluent. Okay. So some of these are, there are a few of them which are default as well, but most of it is, you know, configured accordingly. Now here we are saying max kilobyte of this thing. Buffers and how many acknowledgements you need, instead of, because here we are only saying, even if there's one acknowledgement, saying instead of waiting it to replicate across three brokers, even if the first broker acknowledges, go ahead and accept that it's completed. And how many in-flight requests would be allowed, what is the back off, like, and then what is the
linker.ms,
all those things. Now, I think linker.ms, for instance, in your business, usually we put 1 millisecond, 10 milliseconds for that.
Mm-hmm.
Right here, we have 500 milliseconds so that you can batch in more records and send at once.
Okay.
So, yeah, anyway, so now let's just port forward to this. So long. Okay, so this is the currently configured config, okay, of where it has to go. Now, if you see here, the URL that is configured before is this thing. Somebody were creating, most likely copy pasted, is Elasticsearch client infra v1.es cluster infra, okay? But then the actual but the actual cluster name now is going to be this data-infra-infra. So this has to be, we've removed the client. So this, when we update this URL, right, then it will start working again. Now the problem is it's trying to push to Elasticsearch, but there is no Elasticsearch running available at that URL. Okay, that is why it fails. We just have to update that URL. So Kafka Connect tutorial itself, we already have documented things also. So what it does is, so you've given a topic, it pushes it to a particular index. Okay, so that is all it does.
Kafka Connect, we only create, right, when new environment, we have to create when the new environment, we go to new environment, right? Or it's their part of the deployment pipeline.
No, it has to be created. So as of now, we don't have anything that automatically, let's say, creates these things, right? So that we don't have.
So this connector will be
Okay, so
running
what?
throughout. This connector will be continuously running, right?
Yeah. But once you create, it will be continuously running. Yeah. So in this case, let's try and create it. After this, you can just put your services after. You can give any name here. This URL here needs to change. The URL, and usually these kind of things it will also have to be changed. Telemetry and final messages. Second. Hello. Wait, those 1 sec, trying to get my internet fixed. हेलो। या नितिन, ओके, वर्किंग ना, फाइन। व्हाट इंटरनेट पैकेट कुछ कॉल हुआ। Best I restart my laptop though.
What happened? The connector is not sticking out. Connector?
Okay. It's getting stuck.
Which environment are you?
Hmm?
Which environment are you?
Not environment. Now I'm a PPUAT, but anyway, like I'm just trying to log into anything. Saying time down, okay. बता यार. लेकिन ये रोल का क्या नहीं. रुको रुको, मैं कुछ देर बाद कॉल करता हूँ. वो केटी सेशन पे हूँ. ठीक है. तरुण मुझे हेलो.
या बिल्कुल.
तरुण है हेलो. हाँ करण.
क्या बोल रहे थे समझ ही नहीं आया. अच्छा
नहीं, वो मैं केटी कॉल पे हूँ अभी. कुछ देर बाद कॉल करता हूँ आपको. कुछ अर्जेंट है क्या?
अच्छा अच्छा ठीक है. नहीं वही डिबग कर रहा था. मैंने कहा भाई चांस तेरे को कुछ आइडिया हो कि ये तो मेरे को समझ आ गया कि ओल्ड रोल्स नल आ रहे हैं, बट अब मैं वही देखना है कि ओल्ड रोल्स नल क्यों आएंगे ऐसे. ठीक
हाँ ठीक है ठीक है.
है चल मैं डिबग करता हूँ. कितने बजे गए तेरी केटी?
1:30
है ठीक है।
अरे दैट रिक्वेस्ट दैट आई सेंड ना दैट इज नॉट इन द प्रॉपर फॉर्मेट आई शुड हैव वांटेड इन
अदर रिक्वेस्ट आई हैव फ्रॉम दैट
ओनली लाइक आई डोंट हैव दैट एग्जैक्ट रिक्वेस्ट
आई'ल फाइंड एंड सेंड इट टू
इट इज देयर इन दैट कॉन्फ्लुएंस लिंक ऑल्सो एक्चुअली
या बट आई हैव इन फ्रंट ऑफ It's for some different thing, just see this message.
But I got it.
This actually Kafka Connect create and delete we should put into indexer also dude.
I was planning on putting it now, but then we never got the time to put it. Then yeah.
Before starting you have to create and once it's done you have to
I just put
delete.
that. At least creation though has to be done.
Yeah. This cluster is down, for instance, is that okay? Over up an instant, blah blah blah.
You may have to redeploy everything all at once or what?
Which one?
The whole infra stack or at least the data. You want to restart?
Something seems to be down in infra. How long it's taking you to initialize my god. This will be the Kafka Connect part, okay? So once the Elastic Search is up, it should be able to. You'll have to restart the task in Kafka Connect. There is also another job that we run which will automatically restart those tasks also now. I can see this. So what this does is we will provide the Kafka Connect instances. So every time it runs every time in the, I think, 6:45 p.m. EST, right? GMT. So at that time it runs, and any of these tasks that are in stop state, right, will automatically restart. So we were telling Aniket like auto create, auto delete. So again, this was another problem where it used to get stuck because Elasticsearch is down. But even though Elasticsearch is back up, it will not restart automatically. So this will fix that. What happens is every day it will run, and all the stopped tasks, it will automatically restart those things. Now again, if Elasticsearch, for instance, is still not working, it won't be able to do anything in those cases. But cases.
This is Kubernetes-based cron job, right?
Yeah.
Same like we could like add this in that our, you remember that API cron job we made? So same like that, right? Just
it is the same. It is using. What we had used in that API cron job, right? It's using the same format also, like the common template. But what it does, it'll run a different image. Okay, mm-hmm. The image is this. Okay, what again? That file is also here only. Okay, it is a small shell script. What it'll do, it'll ping that Kafka Connect endpoint. All the connectors which are failed, it'll restart this thing. Instead of manually doing it, it will do it. It will automate that.
So we can find ideal time of Kafka Connect or not? Like how much time it will exist? We create those temporary Kafka Connect connectors, right? For doing legacy indexing. We want to know like if its work gets over, we have to manually go and delete it, right? Once index is done.
So is there any way, means we'll have to find if is there a way like for how much time it has not consumed, or that Kafka connector has not been in use, idle or something, then we can delete it when it's no longer in use.
Okay, that okay. So that won't be there because the idea before behind Kafka Connect, it's like it's a streaming method wherein if it is streaming, it keeps streaming data. That is what continuous flow will always be there. They don't assume that the task will end, means we'll have to delete. But even if it is keeps running the task, there's no harm in anything. It does not do anything.
Processing and people will keep starting those connectors, right?
I mean, you can delete it, but there's no way. I don't think there's any way for us to automatically detect as of
Okay.
now.
It must be maintaining some offset or something, right? How much data it pushed or where the offset is currently on that topic or something.
It maintains it with the Kafka on correct.
Okay. So it acts as a consumer only, right? It operates internally as a consumer only, na? Kafka Connect.
So it actually has a lot of it's architected very well. So you know, I told you about this log compaction and all. It uses all of those to maintain state and stuff in Kafka. So it's actually really cool how they have made this thing to work. So we're just waiting here. As of now, the Elasticsearch is red, right? So you can see here it's slowly reassigning the shards because it's up. Once that is up, we can do the next. In the meantime, any more questions? Let's log again, there's like a couple of things associated in login. I think a total of three components. One is FluentBit, which will scrape the logs and put it to Kafka. Next is Kafka. It will just keep those records there. Then Kafka Connect, which will pick the records from that Kafka and put it to Elasticsearch. Okay. So FluentBit, if anything goes wrong, first point of thing would be FluentBit running. If FluentBit is running, we check whether Kafka in Kafka the messages are going. Now in Kafka, if the messages are coming, then is Kafka Connect working properly to push those messages to Elasticsearch? Whether Kafka Connect is an issue or Elasticsearch is an issue. If Elasticsearch was down and you fixed it, then you can restart the Kafka Connect task so that it'll again restart. If not, every day the job runs and it'll restart, but then if we need it right away, we can always do that.
Our Elasticsearch has gone down, right? Before also. So any
It's there already.
are there or what? You already had a session on it. It documented or you had a session on
Of what?
like what precautions you have to take so that it doesn't go down? Means is there any
No, I realized that we still not have any related to that.
Okay.
Precaution is the thing is you get alerts for that, like okay, whenever things are not working, whenever it's not ready state. Usually most of the time its volume is full. Volume is full, of course you have to fix those things, extend the volume accordingly. Now before the volume full comes also, you get alerts right now. So you fix it before that. If not, now again, these guys are doing a lot of performance testing, which means there's a lot of logs being ingested, right? So a lot of those things might go down, and fixing it is nothing much. You just have to restart and make sure the other issues are solved. Like, is there any file descriptor issues? Is there any memory CPU issues? Okay, the other issue would be storage. If those things are done, then this will start again. If all the pods are in one by one, means it's all healthy, then this process will start wherein it will start relocating the charts and everything will automatically resume.
like we permanently store our logs in Elasticsearch or
what? So after that logs, these are not stored permanently. We rotate them every 7 days.
After 7 days,
So every 7 days we have another job which runs. It's called ES Curator. Again, that is also similar job only. What you have used before, right? We use that same thing. And we tell how many days to, you know, retain and all that. Okay.
It will be just executing delete query in Elasticsearch.
Yeah, it will just delete. So basically all the Elasticsearch eagle service logs, right, that goes, that index name are based on date based. Okay. Mm-hmm. Today's date. So what we do is, if you are saying delete last 7 days, the last 7 days from today, it will get the dates of those, and then from there, it will just delete all of them.
Nitin, there is there should be another one to delete the data in the node as well, right? After scraping, Fluent Bit takes care of it.
No. The node data is automatically deleted by the Kubernetes itself.
So that's configurable, right?
I don't know, but I will have to Google that. I don't think so, but I am not sure. I don't think so. It's configurable.
Okay, so but like now, what is the condition like? How many default days that it retains?
There are like three, four conditions actually where it figures out based on the size, file size. If there's too much size, it will rotate more often, okay, and it will delete it much often. But if the file sizes are normal, there are some thresholds, then it will keep it for a day or so, I think, day or two. Okay. So that's why it's important to get the files out of that into maybe Kafka or something, and then pick out what you want to do with it.
And one another thing, the offset for Kafka Connect, it is maintained in the Kafka, is it? Kafka queue topic itself.
Which one? What did you say? Which maintains for
the offset?
The offset of Kafka Connect. Yeah, my offset of Kafka Connect is maintained in Kafka itself. Mm-hmm. Offset for logs, Fluent Bit is maintained in the node file storage itself.
And offset for ES Curator, it is not there. It is just on the day basis.
Yeah, you just tell last 7 days it's going to try and scrape, remove except the last 7 days. Every other log it is. Okay, so here, see again, if once the log itself, right? If there are way too many log storage, you will also need to increase the appropriate, like, the file sizes as well. I mean, the memory size. Now, here what has happened is once you do something like a memory testing or any of those things, you suddenly require a lot of log ingestion and storage. Even though you are keeping last 7 days, that last 7 days itself, the traffic is way too much, right? And what we are saying is we will give 1,536 megabytes. Which is not enough. So in that case, you will have to increase the memory as well for these instances. Make it work. For the Elasticsearch to work. Now the Elasticsearch is still in red because it's trying to trying to load all of the data into the memory, but it's not able to do that, and it's trying to do a GC. Okay, and it will be stuck there.
Nitin.
One second.
Oh.
Hello.
This is the most interrupted KT session, huh? Lot of interruptions.
You have to edit it.